does. On the ground, enjoyment. We did a very short patrol. Still by the Royal Air Force, which is very recently. And this one, we're going to go back in time. Some of the early days of search and rescue, certainly. Search and rescue using helicopters. We've got a lovely engine though, Dan, that's of the Christian Southern Road turbocharged engine. Yes, I'm expecting a full search and rescue demonstration. Something once again, I've been looking for granted over the years, especially the Sea King. And we're coming in the back of the Wessex, and the East Grand World. 1921. We've deployed a range of aircraft. The problem is none of those aircraft can actually land on the sea. That's the job of the aircraft. Another casualty, destroy someone, offer first aid, offer support. Headquarters speak at the RAF Marine Branch, last year, 1986. Search rescue or air sea rescue, as it was commonly also known in that period, with helicopters started under the control of Coastal Command, and in February 1955, the number 22 Squadron, then stationed at Thorny Island, received its first whirlwind. At that time, the yellow colour scheme you see on this one made its appearance. They were equipped with both winch on the squadron side and a scoop net, and attachments were set up around the UK. And of course, that will happen for many years to come. All sorts of other whirlwind variants were developed. The early ones perhaps wouldn't be the Wasp radio engine before they switched to the Gnome. In between, the Alvis Leondis, which was powering the Sycamore earliest from the Mark 10, the first low rate of 61, led by Storm and Coastal Command and Coastal Command, Training Command. So they would work in a pair, kind of hunter-killer pair, one to find, one to destroy. And it wasn't just in search and rescue roles they were very active in RAF service, and you can see more about that in the center of the space, just behind the control tower, a very camouflaged world which was provided to us by the Yorkshire Helicopter Corporation, which is in colours number 4 Royal Air Force, the United Nations Marking Drive. 84 a unit that went on to operate the And after that, the bell ripping. So that was Andrew Whitehouse completing his sequence on the Westland Whirlwind HAR.10. Well, we had one Alvis Leonides powered aircraft already in the display today in the form of the Sycamore. We're about to hear two more in a fixed wing application and another very rare.